Manhattan Garment District, New York City, USA. Zerkheizi, a former associate of Morgenholt, may be working with someone known as Dvorak to gather classified intelligence about weapons, weaponized algorithms known as the Mask Girls. Determine who Dvorak is and what his relationship is to Zerkheizi. Greetings, fellow things. Welcome back to Splinter Cell Chaos Theory, played as a field interrogator. Now, thus far, Bruce Morgenholt, a scientist who was working on the Mask Girls, these Mask Girls right here. Oh, wait, I don't have a cursor, damn. Weaponized algorithms called Mask Girls, which can be used for information warfare attacks, had been kidnapped. And the third echelon had been busy trying to figure out who kidnapped him. Turns out it was Lacerda, but Lacerda was not the actual person who was, interested in whatever Morgenholt had to offer them. He was actually contacted by somebody else to it, and well, the trail has led to one Ibrahim Zerkheizi, who is actually a colleague of Bruce Morgenholt, and more or less is researching the Mask Girls himself. So, well, with that being the only lead, all we can now do is head over to the penthouse, and that's for real too.
So Zerkheizi and Morgenholt are the only two people who ever saw those algorithms.
And Morgenholt is dead. And Zerkheizi is connected to a mystery guest we know nothing about.
Dvorak.
Morgenholt and Zerkheizi are geeks, not terrorists. Maybe this Dvorak is some kind of puppeteer.
No hitter, bottom of the eighth.
2-0, New York in the eighth.
Akira Watanabe is on the mound. He's pure concentration, pure focus.
This is no coincidence. You're on your way to the Big Apple.
Bruce Morgenholt and Ibrahim Zerkheizi were partnered together on Project Watson, the UN committee that cracked the Mask Girls. They're the ones who discovered 512 encryption, the same encryption used in the messages you recovered at MCAS Bank. If this so-called Dvorak person has somehow gotten his hands on mass-based IW algos, we're in a world of hurt.
I've been trying to penetrate Zerkheizi's private network since we connected him to this mess. I've seen some tough network security before, and I expected Zerkheizi to have top-of-the-line tech, but this is crazy. Zerkheizi's server isn't just impenetrable or invisible, it's like looking for a shadow in a pitch-black room. It's driving me crazy.
Things are turning sour in New York. It's been 24 hours since the blackout, and no one has a clue when it might end. We've got sporadic reports of unrest all over Manhattan, but it hasn't started to spill over yet. Word coming down from above is that the National Guard will be deployed within the hour. We'll need to insert you into an alley behind a building adjacent to the target building. Watch out for civilians.
Well, there's a good reason that Grim can't actually find Zerkheizi's server, and we'll figure out why pretty soon. So let me just go ahead and change my loadout then. Doesn't really matter what you take.
Fisher, the National Guard was deployed into Manhattan about an hour ago.
I feel safer already.
Watch your fire, Sam. Those boys aren't expecting to see you and they'll attack on sight. Do not, I repeat, do not kill any of them.
I'll be careful.
Roger. Good. Lambert. Alright then, so first order of business is to grab this guy and make him talk. And I do believe he does talk. He's one of the more talkative fellows in this group. I'll just wait right here. Let's go towards the back here. A nice little place where nobody will miss you.
Stay calm. We're on the same side.
Jesus! Who are you?
I'm the monster in the closet. And I'm gonna let you go back to sleep as soon as you tell me how many men you have deployed out here.
There's just eight of us in the squad. but there are more on the roof.
How many?
I don't know. I swear.
Thanks for the intel.
I'm just an ordinary guy. Please.
Well, that is true. National Guard, I don't exactly know what the National Guard is or what they're comprised of, but I think they are a voluntary service organization. But strangely enough, they are deployed overseas as well, which is quite strange to me. Anyhow, let's put him back asleep, I suppose. Sam can be intimidating. He can be very intimidating. Without being obtuse. Which is something, which is somewhat of a quality that I really admire about him. Now let's try luring that guy over here. Shall we? Let's go ahead and do that.
This thing's a mess!
It is, isn't it? Come on then. Come on. Don't delay it. I need to grab you. Do not make things more difficult than they have to be. You're still gonna keep the fear in your hand, huh?
All clear.
Of course it is all clear. Why would it not be? But the light is back on now. Well, that was more difficult than it looked. I guess we don't have a window over there. Might as well take the path that we normally do. The places look amazing in this game. Like all the flares and all the lights, the interplay of light and shadow in this game is beautiful to look at. Too bad that you can't exactly take a night vision off for the most part of the game. Otherwise it starts looking like this. Which pleases no one actually, so. I guess he's not going to be chatting with somebody else right now. Okay, maybe I'll just get you guys first. That should make the job easier, I suppose. We should be in a far better position right here.
It ain't supposed to do that, is it? Not as far as I know. 6 weeks out of warranty, and bam, things start screwing up.
You just stay right here. Let's put you down all nice and slow. Like a good little boy. Good job. You guys aren't done it, are you? But one of you is looking here. Looks like you guys aren't really gonna miss your buddy there. There's a pipe over there as well. So if I take this guy out, it's gonna make the next part easy. You don't have anything to see either, apparently. Alright, might as well keep you here. So this is gonna make taking that guy out pretty easy, because there's literally nobody left to see him suffer. Your turn, sir. Would you perhaps have anything to add to whatever your friends might have said thus far? No? Alright, I'll just leave you lying here. Baba Yaga. Baba Yaga actually means, it's supposed to refer to a witch. An old hag. It was never supposed to be about the boogeyman. Don't know why they chose that for John Wick, as a name for John Wick.
Fisher? Looks like the National Guard are trying to restore the power to the building's elevator. That's probably your best way to the top.
I'll see if I can hitch a ride.
It'll be a long climb if you don't.
Alright, let us interrogate you then. Maybe here might be a better place.
Shh. I'm not going to hurt you.
Who are you? Wait a minute. Is this a training exercise?
Damn. Support. This guy knows it's an exercise. Who let the cat out of the bag?
I knew it.
Roger that. Yeah. Okay. Give me a hand here, pal. Just play along. Name, rank, and number.
Corporal Stan Donlan. 24-28-996.
And you're not going to tell me anything else?
Lost no, contact. Sir.
Good boy. All right, want me to move on to the next one? Yeah. Roger. Okay, I'll ask. Command wants to know how many are on the roof.
Two on the roof, sir. Two more inbound in a chopper.
Thanks. Dismissed.
Well, am I dismissed or not? Sir?
You are dismissed. Next guy might be a bit of a trouble, though. He might be a bit of a hassle. Let us go ahead and hope to grab him before he makes issues for us. He sneezed. God bless you. Well, looks like you don't really have anything to add either. Might as well just drag you to the shadows and put you to a long rest. Is that a smoke? Oh, it's a flashbang. Interesting. I've actually never been here to this side of the map, so I've actually never seen that before. Anyhow, can I jump up and grab this? No. I guess it's not strong enough to support Fish's weight then. Okay, we can't exactly use the elevator because the power's out, so we'll have to rely on climbing the ladder instead, in a very MGS sort of sequence. And the light's going back on. I just realized, since Sam is wearing pink trifocals and he is playing, we are more or less playing the game Panther style, doesn't that sort of make Sam like the Pink Panther? Alright, you come with me. Nothing? Alright, you can go back to sleep. Nobody should be noticing you there, but... whoops. One of the downsides of using the 1380 widescreen patch is the fact that it makes... a sort of little body out there in the open over there. Which was my bad. Okay, we need to be heading here. And turn the lights off.
Why should they be on it? No, someone turn them off. Yeah, but they're not supposed to be on. I think something
right.
May be up.
Yeah, something seems to be off. Right? I wonder if it's the lights that's off. Wonder, can I climb up here? Nope, it's barbed wire. Barbed wired. Yes, some of these words are strange. I can't really get the hang of a lot of these words. Barbed wired. Nothing? I would assume so.
Here. It's like I'm being overcautious.
Well, overcautious is better than not cautious at all. Just take this guy for example. He wasn't too cautious. And that got him caught. Your turn now. What would you give for a chance at... well, I don't know. For a chance at being with your friend. For what would you give for a chance to sleep with your friend? Come here. Let me put you two together. Huddled up like two keys in a pod. Now let's just hope that guy doesn't come all the way here. I wanna like interrogate everybody and see what they might respond with. Okay, that's it. That's all they're gonna do. Find them. I'll just go ahead and grab you from behind. While they're not expecting it. And you've got no information for me. So it was more or less a total waste of time. A total waste of my time, anyway. Should not... saving there wasn't necessary. I mean, it was mostly a waste of a save. Not that this game actually keeps tracks of save files, but... yeah. Can we... thank you, Sam. Thank you very much.
Fisher, satellite shows you've reached the Casey's building. County Clerk's office has construction permits on file for the floors below the penthouse and in the neighboring structure.
Any plans or blueprints on file?
I'll have Grim look into it, but with this blackout.
I understand. I'll see if I can dig up some plans down here.
Good idea. Fisher, that's a hired gun if I've ever seen one.
He's no night watchman either. He's a merc. He's got the same kit as the guys who were protecting the Silva.
This whole situation is getting uglier by the second. See if you can find out who these characters work for.
Will do.
Vuko. Yeah, it's still too dark, isn't it?
What are you doing down here?
Who the hell?
Off to a bad start. Talk or die.
Okay.
Tennessee.
We're on VIP protection. This floor. We need to secure it because we can't lock it off from the penthouse.
Does the architect or engineer keep an office or a desk down here?
Yeah, of course. West side of the building.
Since you're doing so well, why don't you tell me the name of the PMC you work for?
I work for Displace. Displace International. You're messing with the wrong company, pal.
I see.
Displace? That's Doug Shetland's company.
Oh, I know. Sam's friend?
Fisher, if Shetland turns out to be crooked...
If Shetland is crooked, I'll take him down myself. But I have a feeling there's more to it than that.
Could be. See if you can find out who's in charge of this protection detail. Maybe someone inside Displace is playing both sides.
You got it.
Yeah, so right now, I don't exactly want to just... I'll try to go ahead and take these guys out.
How much longer is this gonna take? It'll be done when it's done. Done when it's done? What kind of answer is that?
Hey, I got a 220 connection here at 16 amps.
So
you know what that kind of juicy do to you if the wires get crossed?
No.
Well, here. Touch right here and find out.
No thanks.
Yeah, good thinking. Don't get lost. It'll be done when it's done.
So I just want to wait around until that guy gets finished with his, repairs, and then I want to proceed with this section. With my investigations, so to speak. So there's another way over into that corridor right from here. I don't know why they place it like that, but there's a way. And if you choose to take this way to avoid these guys... Ah, there he is. He's done. If you choose to take that way, then you'll essentially be... Maybe I should wait for the other guy to finish his patrol once more before I come back here. I forgot how difficult it is, this section, once this guy is done. so...
What the hell was that?
Good question. What the hell was that? Why don't you come over and find out then? Oh, nothing? All that effort for nothing? Alright. If that is the way you prefer it. Now that this is done, we can actually more or less just...
Who cut this?
That's a very good question. You should totally find out who cut that. And while you do, I'll just chill out here. Right on top of you, where you can't see me. I mean, I could probably use this time to go ahead and interrogate the other guy, but... I guess I'll just wait around for this guy to come.
Nothing.
Exactly, nothing. I wonder why this is cross space here, though. This song always... one of the lines always... sounds to me like Gatorade, like he's saying Gatorade. Are you gonna come back? Or are you gonna just stay stuck there? Oh, thank you so much. And of course I can't grab you from above, like I thought I would be able to. Yeah, so this guy does nothing, so I thought I might as well cool things up a little by doing the choke thing from the rail, but apparently that's not how this game, how this rod is configured. This is there for you to be out of the way as well. Not this guy. People on chairs are one of the biggest problems of this game. Well, not as big of a problem right now, but yeah, you have some news for me. Out with it then.
Like my new knife?
Oh, God!
I've been using it quite a bit. Is it still sharp?
Real sharp?
Maybe you better tell me something interesting before I get all distracted and slip.
Who
medical supplies! You'll probably want some medical supplies! In the washroom, beside the kitchen! I was gonna resign next week! Please!
Alright then, you may go. Alright, so what's on your computer then? 66, 40, 193. Oh come on, seriously? It's not 10, it's 40.
Hmm, work permits, architectural plans. Interesting. Zerkheizi has a hardened panic room off of his bedroom.
I'll check it out.
Looks like he also filed plans for construction in the next building over.
The next building?
I'm no architect, but if I'm reading these plans right, both buildings are connected across the rooftop. I'll leave the relevant data on your offset. Could help you navigate.
Thanks.
Yeah, so that's how you enter the elevator. This is also coincidentally your extraction point. There's nobody across, nobody over here, but there is like a camera there which you need to be careful of. So instead of going into the camera, we're gonna...
Fisher, Zerkheizi's cameras project an infrared beam so they can see in the dark.
If it's an infrared beam, I can see it in my night vision.
Exactly. And listen, it would help us keep tabs on Zerkheizi if we could use these cameras against him.
Gotcha. I'll try and run some taps.
So, there's a guy who's gonna, you know, come across this door right here. And when he does, we're gonna essentially grab him and make him talk. And of course, not gonna be rude and bash the door on him, so... Where's this guy, though, is the question. Am I moving the camera too much? Does it make you feel dizzy? Nauseous, perhaps? Well, I hope not. The neat part about this game is that
Good work, Fisher. That's one camera tapped. There should be five more.
I'll keep my eyes open.
As long as whatever you're doing is in the shadows, the enemies really can't see you. And it's sort of cheeky what the devs did there, but... Yeah, I sort of got caught there. So it's sort of cheeky what the devs did there, but... if you choose to take the elevator, like if you choose to use the elevator after it's done working... you won't be able to get the architectural plans for this building. It'll require a bit of exploration for you since it is so out of the way. I mean, the bonus objective is locked off if you essentially use the elevator after it is done. Alright, this guy now. Okay, so taking this guy out is troublesome. You first take the camera out and then this TV here and hope that he gets distracted.
Did I just see something?
No, you did not. This guy is completely oblivious to Sam standing right behind him. Alright then. Oh, come on. I guess I just missed it at all. Now the television. Come on, come on, come on.
Damn it! What's wrong with this?
Good question. Come here. I've been trying to get you for a long time, and you do have some intelligence for me.
Pick a number between 1 and 10.
What? Oh, crap. 3.
Lucky guess.
Oh, you shit.
Get to live. Now tell me something useful, or we'll play another round.
Oh, God. The mag lock. The locked door to the roof.
What about it?
I think the computer that controls it is in the master bedroom on the top floor.
Is that so?
I told you everything.
I feel like that was a reused line. I feel like I've heard that line before. I don't recall where, but is that... Is that... That looks like Pandora Tomorrow. That's Splinter Cell. All these guys are watching Splinter Cell. Huh. Must be fans of Sam then. At any rate, this next section can be a little tricky. Because we need to deactivate the camera without getting noticed. And I failed. Of course I did. Because why wouldn't I? The bad part about this is the fact that the camera is actually using infrared, so... Anything here? Just this transaction completed. Just an objective for us. Almost got spotted there, my god. This camera is sensitive. I forgot who spoke like that. I think it was the guy in... what's the name of the game again? Not a game, it's not a game. Bridge of Spies. The actual spy.
Gotcha.
Who?
Dvorak.
Where is he?
According to this, he's in the building next door. You can get there across the rooftop through the magnetically locked doors.
How do I get through the doors?
They're not magnetically locked anymore.
Thanks for the help.
Failed log attempts noted from Dvorak to Zerkheizi. Who is this guy, Dvorak? Seems like a hacker of some sort. Maybe the successor to Philippe Mars? Protocol stream 14 initiated, sorry. Field log attempt noted June 29, 2007. Contract employee number. Intrusion. Contract employee. No intrusion. Initiate protocol stream 14. Access code notify. Change 0280. That is pretty much the. What's written there, essentially. We can keep this open, actually. Nobody's gonna look. I want to quickly check the data that I got from that computer there. Not this one, no. Okay, let's try that again then. Maybe we need to get it. We should be able to access it freely now. The data, I mean. Okay, let's keep it as is. The data. Not this, no. The other one. MCS Banco de Panama to Dvorak. Okay, that's basically how we figured out the intrusion. Maybe I should start reading the emails and stuff more often, even though it might say objective. It typically contains some information for us that can add more to the lore of the game. Transaction completed. Senor Dvorak. As per your instructions dated June 24, 2007, the transfer has been made and the payables issued. All transactions have been cleared and trace has been shredded and burnt as permitted under our charter. Okay, some kind of transaction. Most likely the money that was used to pay off Lacerda. For the kidnapping and torture of Morgenholt, that is. Let's take the night vision goggles off. We don't really need it for this next section here.
How long have you known him? Long time. Long time. Since before this place. Since before Bosnia.
Before Bosnia?
Yeah. Good lord. I knew he had connections, but... Yep. I know him a long time. He treats us good, we do what he says.
Yes. Yes, well, he sure treats us well.
Now you know too. Now you work for him. Do what he says.
Yes, well, certainly worth my while now, isn't it?
More than worth your while. It'll keep you alive, man.
Let's hope he doesn't catch us. Whoa, lag. I wonder why. Alright, tell me about your master.
I'm allergic to flowers. Maybe you should talk before I sneeze and accidentally cut your throat.
Oh, God! I'll tell you anything!
Good. Start with your boss. What's his name?
Nedic. Mylon Nedic. He's in charge of all our VIP protection contracts.
And how many of those under his protection has he killed in the last, say, 6 weeks?
What?
What kind of scam is he running?
I don't know about any scam. I swear. Don't hurt me. I'm not as tough as I act.
Mylon Nedic. Echelon's got nothing. He doesn't even exist.
Well, whoever he is, he's playing both sides. We need to inform Shetland.
No can do, Sam. We can't compromise OPSEC for private interests.
Fine. But if I find Nedic, it'll be less of a problem.
Admirable of you to protect your friend, but...
You said he doesn't exist. I'm just correcting a bureaucratic error.
Good work, Fisher. That's 4 of 6 cameras tapped.
I'll keep an eye out for the other 2.
Alright, so... I need to grab this guy, and in order for me to do that, I need to take this camera out. Let's save you. Yeah, so I need to follow a more direct path for this guy. Come on. Right towards the camera there. Before it gets activated again. And this should be a good enough angle to where the camera can't see us anymore. And Sam doesn't really need his MVGs either. He looks angry, this guy. But this guy looks cute looking at Sam. He's like, oh no, please, Papa, don't punish me. Anyway, enough with the weirdness.
Like my new knife?
Oh, God!
I've been using it quite a bit. Is it still sharp?
Real sharp?
Maybe you better tell me something interesting before I get all distracted and slip.
Medical supplies! You'll probably want some medical supplies!
In the washroom, beside the kitchen.
No, I've already been told that.
Please, I've told you all I know.
But the problem is I've already been told that, son. So some of the voice lines are actually recycled in this game. Reused voice lines, I mean. Let us take this camera out again. And let's see. I do recall there being like some sort of a way for us to... Well, I guess not. I thought there was a way for us where we could have opened that door and headed outside, but I guess not. Must have just been my imagination. So there's a guy who's walking around downstairs, and I'm gonna get that guy. There he is. Maybe I should have been a little quicker. And I'm pretty sure I can just stay here. Take my sweet time. Because it's so damn dark right here. Pretty sure nobody will be able to see me. Quite certain that that guy doesn't come here. Alright, we're going for it. But there's a bit of a problem with this section. And the problem is that there's a camera right on our head, over our heads. And there's a guy from the inside who can see everything that we're doing here. Maybe I should not have stuck to this wall here. Well, that works out in my favor. Regardless. Of course. Ah, you do know something. Out with it then.
Like my new knife?
Oh, God!
I've been using it quite a bit. Is it still sharp?
Real sharp?
Maybe you better tell me something interesting before I get all distracted and slip.
Medical supplies! You'll probably want some medical...
So I guess that was that. Nothing of interest there. Now, this next section though. Well, for whatever reason, you're actually more or less in the last zone here. Now, that is to say that this will never work in the realistic mode, but in this mode it does actually work out.
What's going on with the lights here?
Nothing much, but apparently you don't know much either, so... Alright. We'll just choke you unconscious then. And I'm gonna have to shut you off because... No? Oh no. Oh look. I guess we can let the awesome song play. No qualms with that. This is another camera that we need to tap, and I do believe this is a final camera.
Good work on the cameras, Sam. We'll have guys watching Zerkheizi 24/7.
Always happy to keep the donut dippers busy.
Now, digging people out in this section is going to be difficult. Look at this bulb swing. That apparently happens when the FPS is too high. Like if your game is running at greater than 30 FPS, that's exactly what happens. I've got no idea where the other guy is. But I'm just gonna crawl over into this corner right here. Where is he? Oh, there he is. I'm gonna go there and I'm gonna grab him. Hopefully he won't be mad. When I do, I mean. I see where you are. Do you have any sort of information for me? Apparently you do. Well, how about you tell me about it then? And I won't get upset.
What are you doing out here all by yourself?
Huh? Guarding the roof!
From what?
Let me go and I'll show you.
Feisty one. How about I cut your ear off, see how tough you are then?
Oh, shit.
Go ahead. I have two.
How many men do you have out here?
I'm alone on this roof.
Alone, huh? Lousy way to die.
We all die alone.
Well, this guy's a fighter. He gave you nothing.
I know you're too scared to fight me fairly.
Okay. You're right. Well, actually, don't really want to cause a scene. I'll come back. And this time around, I'll fight fairly. That, I do believe, is a... That is a heckler and cook, isn't it? Wait. A heckler and cock. Is that how you pronounce it? Or heckler and cook? I sort of forgot how to pronounce it properly. I think there was something that we could have done out here. I guess not. I must be misremembering things then. So, one of the things that this game will not tell you is the fact that this is a booted up door, by the way. And one of the things, totally against fire code, if I might add. And one of the things that the game will not tell you is that there are people up there who are patrolling. And if you play the game on, the more difficult difficulties, then, there are gonna be like two additional guys up top. But for the purposes of our playthrough, we will be playing this game the way we can play it. Not the way it's meant to be played, but the way we typically play it. So yeah. Now, grabbing this guy is going to be difficult because he's standing right behind the door. Okay, so I guess all we can do at this point is just lure him in. But the door sort of pretends to get stuck on us, on our body.
A trap? Well, nice try, mister. We'll see how smart you really are.
Good thing I was clear of the door, though. Should we? Nah, let's just go all the way over to the corner here and interrogate him over here.
Nice place you got here. Decorate it yourself.
Who are you?
The landlord. Rent's overdue.
What do you want?
Where can I find Dvorak?
Come through! Give me room!
I don't know any Dvorak. If you mean Zerkheizi, he's gone.
So I hope that guy does not catch me. Well, looks like he is going to.
Nothing.
I got lucky.
Better that way.
Man, I got super lucky.
I'll do whatever you say.
I don't really want much, to be honest.
I've been tortured before. I'll cooperate.
Well, that is true. If you've been through torture, you don't want to go through it again. And no, I'm not speaking from experience, but it sounds like a no-brainer, if you ask me. So, if you're too close to these guys, they can sometimes, not scratch sometimes, they can typically know that you're there. Alright, we can wait here as well. Now we've got two options. We can either go get Zerkheizi first. I suppose let's just go and do that. Yeah, let's go get Zerkheizi first. 0280, we got that from, the computer. We could have hacked it as well, but there's no need. Is there? Right then. Let us talk to the old man.
You must be Dvorak.
Well, Dvorak, huh? I had thought this area was, off limits.
You're not Dvorak.
Well, since we're being blunt, well, no.
Who are you?
Such a rush you're in. Fancy some tea, do you?
Lambert, something weird is happening.
I'll say.
What do I do?
The old man seems harmless. Indulge him. See if he knows anything.
This might actually make for like a good screenshot, to be honest. Or even this. If I can just manage to get the things on the side away. Anyway, let's talk to him again. Maybe I'll retain this camera angle instead.
Reminds me of poor old Jiggers. Oh, Jiggers. We hardly knew ye.
Who are you? What are you doing here?
Oh, well, one might ask you the same.
I'm looking for a man named Dvorak.
Ah, Dvorak, yes. Well, you're not going to find one. This way. Yes, here we are then. This is Dvorak.
Jesus. I think I just figured out why you couldn't hack in here, Grim.
Yeah, no kidding.
What the hell do I do now?
Hold on while I find a slide rule.
See what the old man knows, Fisher.
Okay. If this is Dvorak, who are you?
I am Dvorak's keeper. Thank you most kindly for asking.
And what is this Dvorak?
Dvorak is, well, you likely wouldn't understand.
I'm sure you're right. But let's have it for the record anyway.
Dvorak is a mechanical representation of a self-referential axiom of number theory. Dvorak encodes its own logical structure within its own executable cycle and recursively derives a more accurate representation of itself with each successive execution.
That's impressive.
Right. Grim, did you get that?
My God, it's an infinite state machine.
Calm
Fine.
Your tits.
What do I do?
If Zerkheizi is using this...
Grim.
Sorry, Sam, we're gonna need a copy of Dvorak's output so we can work out the algorithm it's built on.
How do I get its output?
It runs on punch cards.
Punch cards?
You'll need to restart the sequence and initialize each tower in the right order, and then retrieve the output stack.
How do I know the right sequence?
You'll need to hit the switches in order as the tubes start to heat up. Ask the old man for help.
Right then. So, Grim's like super excited about an infinite state machine, and I sort of covered this in my stealth playthrough as well, but an infinite state machine is pretty old. I mean, and in the modern day, an infinite state machine is pretty basic as well. It's basically if a machine can process conditional statements, that makes it an infinite state machine. So yeah, just to oversimplify things, the Nokia 3310 was an infinite state machine, so it's not that big of a deal, to be honest.
I need your help.
Indeed. What can I help you with, my good fellow?
I need you to help me initialize Dvorak so I can retrieve an output stack.
Ah, Dvorak. Well, that is certainly something I can help with. Why don't you restart it? I'll initialize the towers on this side, and you can do the other side.
So for those of you who find this a little difficult, using the night vision actually helps. Sorry, the thermal vision. You can see the different, you know, components glowing hot as they get ready. Which one is it? I honestly can't tell. That was the one. Okay.
Whoopsie! Tubes overheated. Seems like we... missed our cue. Better restart from the top there, chum.
I see.
Eventually, Dvorak will derive the answer. But eventually is a very long time.
Just like the oldest machine that Turing made that defeated the Enigma. Ah, there it is. Which one? This one? Are you gonna hit that or am I gonna hit that?
There you go. Mm-hmm. Your output stack should be ready. Mm-hmm. Eventually, Dvorak will derive the answer. But eventually...
Right, you can go now. Thank you for your help. So, this thing seems to be out of a tube. And those are the punch cards right there. You can see the markings. They're called punch cards because you literally punch holes.
All right, I got the stack.
Good work, Fisher. Time to make yourself scarce. Get to your primary extraction point.
On my way.
So, this elevator that is in front of us, that is more or less the primary extraction point. Except, well, we cannot extract out of there as easily. Now, I'm using this detour to more or less grab the rest of the guys that I have not grabbed yet. And there's a wall mine here. It's no harm to me, to be honest. So I'll just ignore it. Still, saving for luck in case this thing decides to just blow up in my face. There's a guy right there, you can't even see him because it's, well, so dark. Weren't you the guy who came downstairs to check on me? Well, you did a pretty sloppy job of it. And the generator outside is also turned off because, well, why not? There's another guy there, and, well, we'll get him. Or so I believe. Oh. Belief. The power of belief is indeed very powerful. This guy's looking right at us, so what we'll need to do is take out that PC over there.
Piece of junk!
Looks like someone's a little jumpy. What's going on, son? Why so jumpy? Well, you don't have any piece of information for me, so you might as well just go to sleep. Alright, that's everybody in this level out. Might as well just use his computer. Automated message. Due to the recent power outage, WNM Newswire servers are temporarily down. We expect the problem to be remedied shortly and apologize for any interruption in your expected Newswire service. Write them. Morale concerns. Planning displays to charge. Charge? Who's charge? Morale concerns. Displays planning? It seems like some pretty... The display seems pretty involved in it all. I understand. It is never easy to ask professional soldiers to undertake simple guard duty. I will look into increasing the rollover rate so that no one is stuck there too long. I'll put Gerald on the rotation later this week to start. Now the question that remains still, just to give displays the benefit of doubt, is the fact that... We can go back down there, or what I like to do is... Well, it would have made for a nice little extraction if there was. But yeah, we can just jump over the side and crush Sam's knees in the process, apparently. Because why not? Oh well. We can leave everything open, nobody cares. I'm just gonna break this lock because there's literally nobody around to notice anything. Anyway. And we're gonna stroll to victory. Yeah, we can walk a little slower. No need to be so fast. As we completely forget everything that we signed for. So yeah, display seems to be pretty involved, but just to give them the benefit of the doubt, I feel like it would be wise to just think that they are more or less protecting Zerkheizi as well, especially since Morgenholt was also under their protection. So maybe Zerkheizi is afraid for his life as well, and he has asked his police to protect him. But at the same time, Zerkheizi is also implicated in the kidnapping of Morgenholt. So maybe it's just the case that Zerkheizi has got the security for himself. Maybe Zerkheizi contracted this place to protect him, and this place just doesn't know any better. Maybe Zerkheizi is actually working with this Mylon Nedich inside of this place. So, I mean, Mylon Nedich is in charge of Zerkheizi's protection detail, so it does make sense, I suppose. So, things are looking a little muddled right now. They don't look as good for this place, to be honest. But let's just hope that whether it's this place or that place, it's all well and good in the end. 100%, 24 enemies knocked out, 15 minutes at the end. Now, one of the things that I dislike about these Panther-style runs, Pink Panther run in this case, is the fact that, well, it takes so long to actually complete a single level. But, oh well, whatever works in the end, I suppose. With that being said, thank you so much for tuning in, thank you so much for watching, and thank you so much for sticking around until the end of level Penthouse. We figured out a few clues as to how this place is mixed into all of this, but what we still don't know is whether this place is a witting accomplice of Zerkheizi or an unwitting accomplice, or whether there's somebody inside this place who is more or less, you know, playing this place, or maybe even both sides, like Sam and Lambert think. So, well, all shall be revealed once we head to the next mission, which is actually this place international. Should have been this place, that place. Anyhow, I think I've overdone that pun a little. That's what we will be covering. This place will be covering. We will be covering this place the next time we come back. And until then, take care. Fare thee well, fellow things.